1. Is there a real King Arthur? The story of King Arthur has been told over and over again over the past 1,000 years. Camelot, the Knight of the Round Table, the Wizard Merlin, and the sword Excalibur are all well known in the Arthurian stories. Several locations in England have legends associated with King Arthur, such as Tintagel, a coastal site believed to be the home of King Arthur. But excavations have yet to confirm Arthur ever lived there or even existed. In the end, it seems that scholars will never know for sure whether there was a real King Arthur or if he was purely fictional. 2. Where is Cleopatra's grave? The location of the grave remains a mystery. In 2010, Zahi Horas, Egypt's former Minister of Antiquities, undertook excavations at a site near modern-day Alexandria known as Taposiris Magna, which contains several tombs dating back to Cleopatra II's reign of Egypt. While many interesting archaeological discoveries have been made, Cleopatra II's tomb was not among them. Archaeologists have noted that even if Cleopatra's tomb survived to this day, it may have been heavily looted and could not be identified. Ancient authors suggest that Cleopatra VII and her lover, Mark Antony, were buried together in a mausoleum after their deaths in 30 BC. The writer Plutarch, AD 45-120, wrote that the mausoleum was located near the Temple of Isis, an Egyptian goddess, and a lofty and beautiful monument containing treasures made of gold, silver, and emeralds, tell, jewelry, pearls, ebony, and ivory. 3. Who assassinated President John F. Kennedy? This is perhaps the greatest mystery in American history that has never been solved to everyone's satisfaction. On November 22, 1963, President John F. Kennedy was shot by Lee Harvey Oswald in Dallas. On November 24, 1963, before Oswald appeared in court, Oswald was shot and killed by nightclub owner Jack Ruby. The most widely accepted explanation is that Oswald killed JFK alone and Ruby killed Oswald. However, there are still many professional and amateur historians who disagree with this interpretation, and since JFK's death, many alternative explanations have been proposed by professional and amateur historians out. Due to the lack of substantial evidence, a consensus may never be reached. 4. Is Caesarion really Caesar's son? In 47 BC, Cleopatra VII gave birth to a son named Caesarion, whom she assumed was the son of Julius Caesar. Cleopatra placed Caesarion as co-ruler of Egypt in 44 BC. However, whether the child is really Caesar's child is uncertain. Caesar never acknowledged the child as his own. One of Caesar's friends, Gaius Oppius, even wrote a book denying that Caesarion was Caesar's son. Cleopatra VII committed suicide after she and Mark Antony lost the battle in 30 BC and Caesarion was killed not long after. There are no remains of Julius Caesar or Caesarion, and scholars cannot determine with certainty that Caesar was really Caesarion's father. 5. Is there a burial pit for money and treasure in Oak Island? For more than two centuries, stories have circulated that Oak Island, off the coast of Nova Scotia, Canada, has a pit of treasure, believed to have been left by the great pirate William Kidd, 1645-1701. During that time, numerous multi-million dollar expeditions came to the island in search of the lost treasure, but to no avail. Despite centuries of searching, no treasure has been found on Oak Island. However, that doesn't stop people from trying to find it. 6. The fate of the Ark of the Covenant. In 587 BC, a Babylonian army, under King Nebuchadnezzar II, conquered Jerusalem, sacked the city and destroyed the first temple, a structure used by the Jews to worship the God. The first temple contained the Ark of the Covenant, which contained the tablets of the Ten Commandments. Ancient documents indicate that the Ark was brought back to Babylon or hidden before the city was captured. It is also possible that the chest was destroyed during the sacking of the city. In any case, the whereabouts of the crate is still unknown. Since its disappearance, several stories and legends about the fate of the chest have been told. One story suggests that the Ark eventually reached Ethiopia, where it is kept today. Another story says that the Ark was hidden by the gods and would not appear until a savior came. 7. When was Jesus born? While many Christians celebrate the birth of Jesus on December 25, it is possible that he was not born on this day. December 25 may have been chosen because it was close to the time of Saturnalia, a Roman festival celebrating the god Saturn. The earliest records of December 25 as Jesus' birthday date back to the 4th century, more than 300 years after his birth. Ancient records show that early Christians could not agree on the date of Jesus' birth. And even today many Christians celebrate Jesus' birthday as on January 6 or 7. Finally, the date of Jesus' birth is uncertain. In fact, even the exact year is uncertain. Although scholars generally agree that Jesus was born around 4 BC. 8. Is the Hanging Gardens of Babylon real? Ancient authors describe a series of wonderful gardens built in the ancient city of Babylon in present-day Iraq. It is unclear when these gardens were built. But some ancient writers were so impressed by the gardens that they called them a wonder of the world. Around 250 BC, Philo of Byzantium wrote that the Hanging Gardens had plants grown at a height above the ground. And the roots of the trees were planted on the terrace and not in the ground. Archaeologists who have excavated Babylon have not been able to find the remains of a garden like the one described. This has led archaeologists to ask, do hanging gardens really exist? In 2013, Stephanie Daly, a researcher at the University of Oxford, suggested in her book that the gardens were actually located in the Assyrian city of Nineveh. Over the past two decades, both Babylon and Nineveh have suffered damage from war and looting. And it seems this mystery will never be completely solved. 9. Where is the Holy Grail? The Holy Grail, the cup that Jesus drank from during his Last Supper with his disciples before his crucifixion, has never been found and almost certainly never will be. In fact, it wasn't until the Middle Ages that much attention was paid to it. After those who wrote several stories about King Arthur described the search for the Holy Grail as a quest that King Arthur and his knights had has done. No scholarly effort has been made to search for the Holy Grail, although it continues to be popular in fiction, being used as a plot detail in films such as Indiana Jones and the Crusades. The Last Crusade, where it was used to heal Indiana Jones after he was shot by the Nazis.